Well, how are you doing today? I got a comment from Kathy, and she was just asking about when she's like chewing food and stuff, she gets like a hissing sound in her jaw. So there's some types of tinnitus where depending on what sort of action you have, it can create sounds. I don't have exactly the same problem, but I definitely have had the problem where when I'm chewing food, I'll get a click, click, click in my ear, and I know how that can be a little aggravating. But what you can do, I mean, you can still play background noise, even some things that have a little bit of a, rumbling around sound in the background, which can kind of help a little bit rather than being in a quiet room and trying to hear the click, click, click all the time. And then second, it's kind of the same thing with just normal tinnitus, where it's a constant sound. You just have to learn to accept that there's nothing wrong here. Nothing's going to happen to you. You have a click. And then, as you are able to just get to know that there's nothing wrong here, you can just, your brain will start to deprioritize it. You can think about other things besides the clicking sound. There could just as well, be some clicking sound in the room happening. You could play a clicking sound in the room, might be a good idea. Just to sort of kind of trick your brain a little bit away from the clicking sound that you hear. But what we're trying to always do with tinnitus is get where we're not judging this as something that's really important that we have to solve. Because that's really, in essence, what happens to people who are having trouble with tinnitus is they have this sound and they feel they need to solve the problem. But the feeling that they need to solve the problem is what makes the sound ever so more present in the present time. They can really focus in on it and hear it more because they're focusing on it. So we want to try to do all kinds of things to learn to not focus on it. And as we say, don't think about it, don't think about it, don't think about it, you're gonna think about it, right? But as you are successful in not thinking about it, the sound will decrease for you. It'll get where you don't really notice it so much. And when you do, you don't care. That's what we wanna get to. And it's really amazing once you're able to do that, because it really is like a lot quieter, and it's not a problem. If it is a pretty loud, like hissing sound or whatever, you might just have to accept it's the normal me. But you could be smiling and eating and tasting delicious food and still have a clicking sound, not worry about it. And by all means, like I always say, if you're worried about what is the sound, then go to the doctor, let them check your ears and so forth, and let them. The sound itself is surely not a problem. And you want to convince your subconscious brain of this, and then you can sort of just like tune it out. You're not worried about it. There's all kinds of things that we can worry about, aren't there? Whether it be money or our relationships with other people. There could be something wrong with our body. There could be some thing coming in the future that we can't predict what the result might be. Maybe it's today's elections. Maybe you're worried about who's going to win and who's going to lose. But let me tell you, we're going to be here tomorrow again, and we're going to keep on moving on with what we're doing. So a lot of what we deal with in tinnitus is very similar, or is related to how we deal with anxiety. And anxiety is, we're concerned about what might happen. And we have that calculating part of our brain that's always trying to calculate what we might do if what might happen happens. I think maybe it's good sometimes to be able to say, what is the percentage chance of that happening? Because in the case of a clicking sound, and after the doctor's told you you're going to be fine, what is the percentage chance that this is actually going to cause some problem? Very, very, very low, right? You know, even if the election doesn't go your way today, the way you hoped it would, what is the percentage chance that suddenly, you know, you're going to be out on the street and your life's going to be up, torn upside down? And, you know, there's always a chance, but it's pretty low, you know, that it's going to happen. And we don't want to spend, we don't want to waste too much of our time thinking about things that could happen when they haven't happened yet. So part of curing the anxious brain is learning to put your attention on things that move you forward and help you to progress. You know, I took a Chinese lesson online. I'm always writing Chinese, and there's always something interesting. I learned how to say where there's a will, there's a way in Chinese. Yo zhi zhe shi jing cheng. And, you know, it's just like where there's a will, there's a way. That's a good thought, isn't it? You know, whatever you've got going on, if you just set your mind to doing something, you can move something forward. I don't know what it is, but in my case, maybe it's Chinese. Maybe I'm having a tough day, so I'm going to sit down. I'm going to study a video. I'm going to write Chinese. I'm going to study some sentences. Maybe I'll take a lesson online. Whatever I got to do, but I'm going to get doing something that's helpful to me, that'll move me forward in some way, and or maybe help somebody else. You know, get busy helping somebody else. But this is the anxious brain at work when we're always calculating what might happen and how we might respond to it. And our brain's really good at that because it wants to save us. if there's a you know, like a big dog running after us, and it's, you know, it might and bite us. You know, we our brain is really good at running and defending ourselves and going into panic mode, but we don't want to be in that mode all the time. You know, that's not effective. Obviously, if there's a dog chasing you, that's one thing. But anxiety, that's what it does, is it kind of puts us in this state where we're ready to you know, what's the word? Come into action and do something. And when you have this tinnitus sound, you get into that state. I've got to do something. Oh my God, I've got a clicking. Oh my God, I've got a ringing. I've got to do something. And see, that's not the state we want to be in. And as we get out of that state and we get into, I think I'll study some Chinese. Oh, that's an interesting character. I'll learn how to write that one today. You know, maybe I'll write it 100 times and not think about my tinnitus, you know, whatever. You know, but that's what we have to learn how to do, is just keep bringing our mind to a place that is helpful to us. You know, I've got my little safe places. It could be singing a song or Chinese or dancing. And you need to find your safe places where you get your thoughts in a place that's helpful, and maybe develop some new ones as well. And hopefully you'll be well on your way to letting this tinnitus thing not even be anything anymore. Just let go of whatever the clicking is or the ringing. And, you know, I'm sitting here in a quiet room right now, and I just realized, yeah, I do have that sound back there. It's been here the whole time, but I'm peaceful. You know, I'm not worried about it, but it's certainly a constant ring. Maybe I should smile about it. Why do I have to do something? I don't have to solve anything. I've just got a ring, you know? Sure. I can go a long time, maybe the rest of my life like this, and I'll still be fine, you know? I'm not saying things that are not helpful to me. So many things I could do that are worthwhile, and I'm going to do those things. And actually, I'm going to go dance now. So you guys have a wonderful time. Whatever you find, go find something and do it, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.